In this video, I want to talk a little bit about the different types of group rules that you have in small groups. And we're focusing in this video on informal group rules, which have more to do with the function of a group rather than, you know, assigned positions such as, you know, president or leader, whatever. Not things that have been assigned, but roles that people gravitate toward because of their personality or because of their skills or because of group need or whatever. These informal group rules are what we're going to focus on today. So there are three basic categories and types of roles that you find in groups. One is a task role, then you have the maintenance roles and the disruptive roles. The first two, task and maintenance roles, tend to have a positive effect on the group, tend to be constructive for group communication and group process. The disruptive roles, however, as you might guess, tend to be a little bit negative, have a negative effect, more of a negative effect on the group function. But let's start with the task roles and work through some of those. First, you have the initiator contributor. And this is the person who, when your group first gets its assignment and they say, okay, get together and figure something out. But what? Well, the initiator contributor is the person who starts throwing out ideas. Well, here's how we could approach this. Or what if we take on this problem? Or what about this issue? And they start throwing out some ideas. And that's really important for getting a group off of those starting blocks and really getting some forward motion. A lot of times that's where groups stumble, is right out of the starting block. When they don't have any ideas, don't know what to talk about, don't know what to take on, the initiator contributor is the person who can put up some ideas there and throw out some ideas and help a group really get started on some things. Then you also have the information seeker. The information seeker is sort of like the person when you have a plane crash or something, the person who says, okay, what resources do we have here? Who has some water? Who has some rope? Who has a first aid kit? Who has some medical knowledge? Those types of things. That's an information seeker. And in the small group function, that's really critical because this information seeker then says, okay, where do we have experience in this? Who's done this type of thing before? Who has some expert knowledge in this area? Who has connection to some different resources? And they start pulling those things together so that the group has a good idea of what they already have and what they're working with to start with, right? So that information seeker position is really important in determining what resources and what information the group has from the get-go. The information giver sort of works in a symbiotic way with the information seeker, in that once the information seeker has figured out, this is what we have, these are the resources that we have, this is where we're at right now, the information giver can then fill in the gaps then that are created, that are realized then, and say, okay, the information seeker has discovered that we have information on all this stuff, but we're missing some of this area, so let me go do some research, let me go find some resources that I can provide with the group, that I can provide the group with in terms of what we need. So the information giver is filling in those gaps then. What does the group not have? What does the group need? They're going out doing research and making those connections. The opinion seeker is the person who is making sure that everybody in the group is heard, making sure that there is true consensus and that it's not just a vocal minority kind of steamrolling over the other members of the group. But you know, especially for those quieter members, that's important. Those quieter members may have some good ideas, may have some good experience, but may not be comfortable speaking up. So the opinion seeker is the person who's stopping and saying, okay, let's take a time out before we go any further. Are we really in consensus? Do you have something to contribute here? Are you on board? We haven't heard much from you yet. What are your thoughts here? And pulls that information out and make sure that we really have group consensus and that we really have the involvement of the whole body of the group and not just a select few more vocal members of the group. The clarifier elaborator is somebody who kind of pulls together those different threads. And so I think, you know, we kind of talked about this over here, so let's pull it back to what we're discussing here and see how that connects. Or I think what this person was trying to say is this, and maybe they brought this point up earlier. And so they're just trying to pull together all these different threads, and they have that really good skill about being able to do that. Some additional task roles that we see. First, the coordinator, which is, you know, not a glamorous role, but nonetheless a very important role. Somebody has to determine and make a reservation and arrange for where this group is going to meet. How are you going to have supplies? Are you going to have, you know, pens and paper and things for people to write with? Are you going to need some multimedia stuff? So this person's coordinating that. And so this coordinator plays a really pivotal role. Otherwise, you know, people don't know where to go and don't know, have the things that they need. So again, not a very glamorous role in some ways, but nonetheless a really crucial role. As a secretary recorder, along those same lines, not a very glamorous role, but still very important. Secretary recorder acts as sort of the memory of the group and serves that function. documents the different ideas that the group is discussing, documents the different decision points that a group reaches, and what decision was made then, and if need be, you know, what was the vote, so that later on when we're going through and saying, no, we already talked about that, and the secretary recorder can say, yes, we made a decision on this point, on this date, and here was the vote, and here was the decision that was made. And so you have a record of all those things, and just somebody keeping track of all the ideas that are flying around that you know, other people may not be noticing. So that secretary recorder position, absolutely critical. Next, you have the facilitator. The facilitator sort of acts as a referee of some in some capacities here, and says, oh, okay, I think we've reached our discussion time on this, so we need to move forward with the decision. Let's bring this to some sort of decision point, or I think we've gotten off track here. We started talking about something that doesn't really fit into our group's task, so we need to bring it back around here. That facilitator sort of acts as a referee, makes sure everything in the group and the group discussion is staying on task and in bounds, and it's related to what that group is trying to accomplish. Then that facilitator makes sure that they're not leaving the guardrails there. They put up those guardrails and keep them on track. And the devil's advocate, you know, may sound like a negative thing because it's got the word devil in it, but the truth is the devil's advocate is an important role in a group. Somebody to say, as Lee Corso does a lot, not so fast, my friend. Let's think about this in a different perspective. Have you considered this? Let me play the devil's advocate here and argue against that just to make sure your ideas are holding up. That devil's advocate role is really important, trying to punch holes in different arguments, not in a mean way. This is a constructive thing, just to make sure that we've covered all of our bases, that we've really thought this through, that we're not missing some, you know, major blind spot here. That devil's advocate is really important in fulfilling that type of function. So apart from task functions, which has to do with, obviously, the effectiveness and the tasks of the group, the group also has a social dimension that needs to be cared for and considered. And so that's where these maintenance roles come in. They perform an important role in the social function of the group. First, you have the supporter and encourager as a type of maintenance role, for example. This person acts as sort of the cheerleader, which you need, especially in those tough times in a group. A group hits a wall, a group's getting stagnant, a group's getting frustrated with one another, and they're not making enough progress. You need that supporter encourager to say, we're doing a good job, you're doing a good job. I really like the ideas that you shared today. I really like the direction our group is heading in. I know it's slowing down a little bit, but we just need to keep pushing. We've done so much good work so far. You need that supporter and encourager. And that's not everybody, but somebody in that group hopefully will be able to fulfill that role, because it is really important to keeping up group confidence. Then you have the harmonizer and tension reliever. This is the person, again, it's sort of, we had a referee for the task functions and that facilitator. We almost have a referee for the maintenance roles as well in the harmonizer and tension reliever. This person may be able to, as a whole group, may be able to, you know, make a lighthearted comment to kind of relieve the tension a little bit, but they're also the person who pulls people aside and says, okay, we've got something going on here that's not task related. Let's see if we can hash this out in a positive way. Let's get back on the same page. And not even to say that everybody has to be best friends, but let's get to a point where we can work functionally together and be on the same page together for the function of this group and for the lifetime of this group. So that harmonizer tension reliever, sort of a referee among the social parts of the group as well. And then the gatekeeper and expediter, they really keep control of the channels that are used amongst the group, and keeping like a time as well on the discussion of things that are happening within the group, and the channels that are being used, as I said there before, so that gatekeeper kind of manages where that information comes from and how long we spend on it and what's good and what's garbage and sorts all that out for the group as well. So you have those maintenance roles and you have the task roles. Again, as I mentioned, they're fairly positive functions in a group, tend to be fairly positive functions in a group. But we also have these disruptive roles that tend to be have more of a negative impact on the group. And so hopefully these are things we can avoid and that the group can manage, but they will crop up and they will pop up, and we will need to manage them. The leadership of the group or the group as a whole will need to manage them and try and minimize them. First, you have the stage hog, right? The person who... It doesn't even have to be about the task, it doesn't have to be about anything, but they just need that attention. They have to be on the stage, have to be the center of attention, even if it means doing something disruptive. So And they may just talk and talk and talk and talk and be the loudest. It doesn't even mean that they have good ideas or anything like that, but that stage hog just wants the attention, wants to be the center of attention there. So we need to kind of manage that as best as possible. You might have the isolate. The isolate is the person who may pull themselves apart from the group, may seat themselves apart from the group physically, in a physical sense, or may just not show up, may isolate themselves. And this is really easy to do when you have a virtual group. It's particularly common in virtual groups because it's really easy to just ghost people and just stop showing up and stop contributing. And at some point, the group may decide they need to just cut that person out entirely and not include them in the group anymore, quite frankly, not have them be a part of the group. But you'll have this person who will kind of isolate themselves and separate themselves from the group for whatever reason. Sometimes you have a clown, somebody who just, and this isn't an attention reliever thing, it's just somebody who, again, needs that attention, wants the attention to be focused on themselves. It's almost like a cousin of the stage hog in some ways. This clown needs to have the attention, so they just make jokes, whether they're appropriate or inappropriate, and they clown around and play practical jokes and do things that really just disrupt the flow of the group and disrupt the social harmony of the group as well. You may have a blocker, and this may be a blocker. This blocker is somebody who just is intent on seeing the group not be successful. It could be because they don't want to be a part of the group in the first place and were assigned there and just are doing what they can to be a pain. It could be because their idea didn't get, you know, accepted by the group or didn't get enough recognition by the group, they didn't feel like, so they're blocking all the other efforts of the group or whatever. But you have these people that just are working against each other, working against the group, and sometimes for reasons that may seem to make sense for them, but either way, it really disrupts the effectiveness of that group. You have the fighter controller. I mean, you probably know some people like this who just, for whatever reason, like to try and start a fight, like to be difficult, like to challenge people, and not in a good way. Again, it's one thing to challenge people as a devil's advocate in an appropriate way, and to bring, you know, counter arguments to the group to try and make the group more effective. But these fighter controllers are just trying to pick fights, just trying to be difficult, for no other reason than that they can, and that they either want control of the group, or they lost control of the group and want it back, or whatever. But they're starting fights for whatever reason, and it's not helpful, it's not functional, it's not constructive for the group. You may have a zealot. You may have somebody who is a part of the group who either so fervently believes in that group's cause, but one specific part of it, that they won't stop talking about it, or that, you know, for whatever reason, but they can't listen to reason, and they won't compromise it in any way, and what they're suggesting is just not realistic and not functional. So, but they continue to just bang that drum and not give an inch on anything. So the zealot is not helpful, and that's somebody who needs to be reined in as well, so that they can contribute constructively to the group. And then finally, the cynic. This is sort of the kind of the Eeyore function, if you're familiar with that character from Winnie the Pooh, the Eeyore function. Oh, everything is awful. Oh, this, that idea will never work. This is never going to get off the ground. We're never going to get anywhere with this stuff. And they, just everything that comes up, they just have the most negative outlook. So you got to find a way to turn that person around, or at least tune them out in some ways. But hopefully you can turn that person around and just show them some positive traction that the group is getting, and say, come on, join us, get on board, you know. Turn that frown upside down, so to speak, and don't be the cynic. Be a constructive part of the group. So you do have these disruptive roles that'll need to be managed, and they'll pop up. You never know when or where, but they'll pop up. So they will need to be managed by the group or by the group leadership or a combination of the two. As always, if you have questions about these types of group roles or about anything else from the content that we've talked about, please feel free to email me. I'm always available via email, and I'd be happy to discuss this and any other small group communication related questions with you. Thanks.